singing. Jay Flynn! I'm so excited. Also, you have been very excited this week because Taylor herself liked that post.
Yeah.
Is that the most important like of your career?
100%. Yeah, I think it's pretty funny that, like, someone double-tapping on a screen has led me to be, like, on the news right now. But no, on, like, I idolise Taylor. I think she's, like, the artist of our generation and the best songwriter and such an amazing businesswoman. And if it was her, like, it could have been someone from a team,
no,
I don't know,
it wasn't,
but if it was her,
like,
I did that cover and I thought I was going to get so much hate. So I'm like, I've been on cloud nine ever since, and I can't believe it.
I don't think that you actually thought that Taylor may see that, because can we remind you of this is what you said before you recorded that?
Taylor's too busy to be watching a Like a Virgin by G Flip, but if she did ever see it, I'd say, you know, maybe one time I should play drums for you, maybe. That'd be pretty cool, Taylor.
Yeah.
That's not aged well.
I'm still sus if she actually saw it or not, but honestly, like, yeah, I was asleep and then I looked at my phone and it was like exploding, and then I was like, what's going on? And then yeah, apparently she liked it. So best day of my life.
Well, it's not just Taylor that saw it. People are going nuts. The stats on your music are insane. I've got it here. 6 million views TikTok, 6 million on Instagram, 600,000 on YouTube already. You obviously weren't ready for it to explode like that.
No, I swear to God, I thought everyone was going to hate it. I really thought, like, you know, Taylor Swift fans, like, and I'm such a fan, like, the music is so precious, and I just love Cruel Summer. I think it's one of the best written pop songs of all time, and it's what me and my band listen to before we go on stage. So while I was on tour in the US in, like, November, I was like, oh, my God, I really want to do a cover of this song. And so I really thought it was going to get backlash, but I just really loved it, and I loved putting my own arrangement to it, and I had so much fun, so I just did it anyway. But I honest to God, did not think I would get a response like this. And I feel like for anyone making music, I think if you like it, that's a good indication and you should just do it. Don't worry, you know, if you think people are not going to like it or not, because, yeah, it's, you know, I've gained so many new fans and so many people discovering me from this, I guess.
Now, tell me, I heard this, tell me if, I don't know if this is true or not, but did your mum start a petition for you to open for Taylor Swift when she's out here? Is this true?
My mum did start a petition. And I know, go Lisa. I was having a chat with mum and, like, the other day, and, you know, she's so cute. She's just like, well, why aren't you opening for Taylor? Just call your booking agent. I was like, mum, she's the biggest artist in the world. It's not that simple. But I think she's taken matters into her own hands and she's started. But I think it's only got like 90 signatures. But if anyone wants to go sign mum's petition.
Where can we find it? Because we're going to get onto it now. Where's my phone?
Mum's handle on Instagram is legitimately G Flips Mama. She's got two posts and she's posted about the petition. So,
well, that's going nuts now, isn't it?
Yeah. Go, Mum. She's been texting me all day. Like, we've got 20 signatures, 30 signatures every 10. So, yeah, it's just really sweet
that's
to
the
have.
Mum thing I've ever heard.
It's really sweet.
In all seriousness, have your people heard from Taylor's people? Like, are you?
Oh no, I feel like that's, you know,
that's
I'm down here
away.
Just, you know, in Australia doing my drums and Taylor's in another universe. But, like, the fact that she even maybe saw it and liked it is, like, made my whole life. So I'll never forget that moment.
I just want to ask you about the song itself. Teddy Swims also did a version that dropped on the same day in the BBC Live Lounge. What is it about that song that's so malleable? Because your versions are so different.
First of all, Greatest Bridge of all time. That bridge is just the greatest bridge. The songwriting is, like, just incredible. For me, that song, like, you know, it's about, like, a kind of like a summer romance, but it's kind of in secret, you know? So, you know, for me personally,
growing up queer, like I had, you know, relationships like that when I was growing up where, you know, there's a line in the song, I don't want to keep secrets just to keep you. And that, you know, for me being queer growing up, like, you know, having queer relationships that you didn't feel comfortable to share out loud, like, I feel like me and other queer people who love Taylor Swift, that song's always been, like, had a special place in our heart. Mm. And then it's just a banger. Like, that song, that song rocks. It's so good.
The good news is that the cover of Cruel Summer is available to stream from tomorrow. This is normally where we'd say goodbye, G-Flip, but we're all about to enjoy watching Sam try to learn sumo wrestling.
Yes.
We'd like to invite you...
Stuff my story. This is really...
Well, stick around if you'd like.
You, okay, well, when you look at me, do you think I can take on a sumo wrestler?
Absolutely not.
Okay, terrific. Terrific. Great.